The Philippines receives over 362,000 more doses of Pfizer's COVID vaccine. The government bought jabs arrived in Manila and Cebu Wednesday evening. Cebu and Davao were allocated around 50,000 shots each, while Metro Manila will get the rest. The latest vaccine shipment comes as many provinces clamor for more supply. One lawmaker has sought a probe into why local government units are no longer allowed to procure their own jabs through multi-party agreements.
Ang gagawin ng mga NGOs, kukulitin at kukulitin nila yung mga in-charge dyan sa vaccination natin. Kung sino pwede nilang makulit at sabihan na hihingi kami ng vaccine. Eh kung hindi pala makulit yung governor, hindi kayo makukuha. You know? So kung hindi siya makulit, pero he has the funds. Yes. And they purchased through an MPA. Why not give, I mean, the concept of our republic is autonomy. Mm-hmm. Of all this local government. Ang gagawin ng mga NGOs.
Said, several drug makers no longer accept vaccine orders through tripartite agreements because of the complicated process. Senator Panfilo Lacson suspects a mafia may be behind the procurement of expired medicines under the Health Department. The lawmaker showed this trend of questionable purchases during Wednesday's Senate probe. The amount in question, 2.73 billion pesos in the last 8 years. The bulk of the purchases happened in 2019. But Health Secretary Francisco Duque III explains the medicines in question may simply have not been used in time.
It's pwedeng nag-retire na yung iba, pero pinalitan ng natutong bagong miyembro ng mafia. Sana kung isang taon lang tapos nawala, maaaring kapabayaan lang. Pero pattern na po ito eh.
Baka hindi lang siya gumalaw kaagad at lumapit na doon sa kanyang expiration.
I think an investigation is in order to find sir. Bakit lagi na lang ganito yung ating pagbili o pag-procure ng drugs and medicines.
The Budget Department needs President Duterte's 10-day timeline to release funds for the payment of special risk allowances to public and private health workers. The 311 million peso fund will be given to 20,000 medical workers directly catering to COVID patients. They will receive a retrograde payment of not more than 5,000 pesos per month.
Kumbaga po, bola na ng DOH ngayon yan. Sila na magdi-distribute at magda-download yan sa 20,000 plus healthcare workers in the private and government sector. Anong ina-assume namin, meron naman silang binigay na listahan sa amin. So, it's a matter of distributing it to yung dun sa mga taong hindi nakatanggap nung first tranche. Napansin ko yung release mas malaki yung sa private.
But health worker groups are not satisfied. They are also calling for the payment of several other promised benefits such as meal, accommodation and transportation allowances, and active hazard duty pay. Some of them have also yet to receive compensation for COVID-19.
Doktor po talagang nangyayari sa kanila, hindi lang 24, 48 hours po. Super hanggang sagad na po sa lupa ang understaffing ng mga kanya-kanya mga hospitals.
Health workers plan to stage daily protests until September 1st, the deadline they gave government to release. Some groups are also threatening to hold mass resignations. World Health Organization sounds the alarm over the continued increase in COVID-19 cases in Western Pacific nations. Over 6 million people across the region have been infected, with Indonesia, the Philippines, and Malaysia having the highest number of cases.
Surges are pushing health system dangerously close to what we call the red line, where the number of critical cases exceeds ICU capacity, and the hospitals can no longer provide the care that people need. Getting priority populations, especially health workers and older people, and then whole communities, vaccinated as quickly as possible is crucial. But equally critical is continuing with the personal protective behaviors and public health measures that reduce transmission.
On Wednesday, the Philippines logged over 13,000 new coronavirus infections, bringing the number of active cases to more than 125,000. 228 new deaths were also reported. A local researcher sees cases dropping by next month as the ongoing lockdowns in various areas take effect.
In business, a new study shows the slow rollout of COVID vaccines will cost the global economy some $2.3 trillion. The Economist's intelligence unit warns countries which fail to vaccinate 60% of their populations by mid-2022 will suffer the losses over the next 3 years. Emerging and developing economies will be the most affected. The study adds COVAX, the international effort to provide COVID shots to poor nations, has failed to live up to expectations. So far, more than 5 billion vaccine doses have been administered globally. 40% of these were given to in China, India, and the U.S.